got a brand new one I'm gonna share with you tonight. Are you ready? Goes like this. You make the
blind man. Hello, welcome to another Wednesday in the Word. I know that you and your family are well. You're blessed. You are experiencing the grace, the peace, the love, the joy of God our Father. Listen, God is great, and He is greatly to be praised. I am so excited that you have tuned in on this another Wednesday to lift up the name of Jesus, to glorify His name, and to study to show yourself approved unto God. Tonight, we're going to begin a series on different topics and discussion issues, some things that some have written in. We're going to begin our discussion tonight, and tonight it takes place outside. This subject matter deals with us outside of the church walls. We're going to be talking a little bit about evangelizing. We're going to talk about witnessing. We're going to talk about the responsibility that you and I have as sons and daughters of God to make disciples. Our very own Pastor Eric Johnson, he's going to lead us in our biblical study and pouring into us and giving us some scripture and giving us some application so that you and I can evangelize the lost to Jesus Christ our Lord. Pastor Eric is going to come in just a few moments, but before we do that, we want to just take a few moments and get into this zone by praising and worshiping our God. So get your Bibles, get your notepads, and tune in and be blessed as we enter into His courts with praise. God bless you. Enjoy tonight's study.
There's a sweet, sweet spirit in this place. And I know it's the spirit of the Lord. Come on and lift those hands. There's a sweet, sweet spirit in this place. And I know it's the spirit of the Lord. Right where you are, declare this, say, sweet, holy spirit. Say, sweet heaven. I want you to stay right here with us, feeling us with your love. And for these blessings, we will lift our hearts and pray. Without a doubt, we know that we have been revived. When we shall leave this place, I am the Lord that heal and thee. I am the Lord, your healer. The Lord says, I send my word, lift your hands right where you are, to heal all disease. I am the Lord, your healer. Come on, right where you are, begin to lift your hands. The Lord says, I send my word to heal all disease. I am the Lord, your healer. Come on, I feel that thing so deep in my spirit. He says, I send my word to heal all disease. I am the Lord, your healer. Where you are, it says, I send my word to heal all disease. am the Lord, your healer. Come on, lift those hands and sing hallelujah.
Greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Yes, it is Wednesday in the Word, and I'm excited. I want to thank God for the opportunity to just stand before you right now, because he didn't have to do it. It is because of his tender mercies and his loving kindness. His mercies are new every morning. Great is his faithfulness. Great is his faithfulness towards us. Welcome to Wednesday in the Word. A special greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ to our pastor, Pastor Christopher A. Bourne. Thank you for entrusting me to feed the flock on tonight as we touch on this topical message of how we can evangelize. How Christians can evangelize. Also, a special greeting to our Bishop Emeritus, the Bishop Dr. William LaRue Delard, and all that he has poured into me to be able to operate in the office of Associate Pastor of Second Baptist Church in the evangelism ministry. Thank God for you, and thank you. Let us pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I thank you and I praise you for this day. Please, please, Lord, forgive me of my sins. Why? Because you're worthy to be praised, and nothing I can do ever can be worthy of the things you have done for me and for us and for Second Baptist Church as a whole. Please, please forgive us of our sins. We're thankful that you've left your word. We're thankful for your son that you sent, Father God, to be the propitiation for our sins. And we ask you, Lord, we beg you for forgiveness, Lord. Please forgive us of our sins. Have mercy upon us. Lord, thank you for your word, and please continue to bless us as we dive into how we can share you, share Jesus, share the power of the Holy Spirit with others here in on earth, Father God, and in our immediate sphere. And whenever we get an opportunity, we should be sharing the gospel. So empty Eric out, Father God, right now in the name of Jesus, and pour in your Holy Spirit and allow me to teach, Father God, the things that you've poured into me to share with the body of Christ here at Second Baptist Church on tonight. I thank you and I praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Praise God for this opportunity. So I thank God for this opportunity to share this brief topical study on what we can do as men and women of God to evangelize, and its basis, or the basis for this evangelism. Now, evangelism is sharing of the good news. That's the euangelion, or glad tidings. That is the euangeliso of the gospel of Jesus Christ. You've heard that before. That salvation has come into the world. The works of Satan is defeated. And anyone who calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. That is good news. The first mention of the good news of the gospel of Jesus Christ can be found in the book of Genesis, chapter 3, verse 15. And this is called the proto-evangelium. That is the first mention of the gospel of Jesus Christ. And it is in Genesis chapter 3, verse 15. And it reads, amen. And I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your seed and her seed. He shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel. This is the word of God. This is the curse placed on Satan to let him know that God would send someone to defeat what he had already done by deceiving Eve and Adam in the garden. And then sin, the sin that we're born in, entered into man. And that's why Jesus had to come back to save us from the wrath of that sin. This is good news because all of the prophecies, all of the theophanies, all of the Christophanies, all of the typings and allusions and ceremonial feasts in the Old Testament point to the coming of Jesus the Christ. All of the covenants that God made with Abraham, with Moses, with David, point to Jesus the Christ. Amen. Now, such prophecies as the Emmanuel prophecy, which simply reads in Isaiah chapter 7, verse 14, therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son and shall call his name Emmanuel. That is God with us. This is the word of God. This same Emmanuel would come into the world as a direct fulfillment of the Old Testament scripture to save his people from their sins. Evangelism is not just a New Testament doctrine. Let me say that for you again. Evangelism is not just a New Testament doctrine. It's not just a New Testament office or expectation. There are many examples of Old Testament evangelism as well. Now, the Apostle Paul pointed out in the book of Galatians, and let us turn to Galatians chapter 3, verses 5 through 9. And it reads, therefore, he who supplies the Spirit to you and works miracles among you, does he do it by the works of the law or by the hearing of faith? Just as Abraham believed God and it was counted to him for righteousness, therefore know that only those who are of faith are sons of Abraham. And the scripture, foreseeing that God would justify the Gentiles by faith, preached the gospel to Abraham beforehand, saying, in you all the nations shall be blessed. So then those who are of faith are blessed with believing Abraham, the word of God. Amen. The introduction of Psalms 67, which is also backed up by Numbers 6:25. And may God be gracious to us and bless us and make his face to shine upon us. And then it goes on further to say, may he lift up his countenance upon us and give us peace. Amen. Israel was called to faith and repentance in Ezekiel chapter 18, verses 30 through 31. Israel was called to witness to their children in Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 7. Israel was called to witness to their neighbors in Jeremiah chapter 31, verse 34. David's call was to witness to the nations in Psalm, in the 18th number of Psalm, verse 49. And David's confidence was that all nations would bow down in humble submission to the Lord in Psalm 22, 27. The prophets had missionary work. Zechariah chapter 8, verse 23. I love personally the story of Ruth as she clung to her mother in love, Naomi. Now, this was the direct result of how Naomi lived her life out in front of her daughters in the land of Moab after so much pain and suffering. Ruth 1, 14 through 17 reads, then they lifted up their voices and wept again, and Orpah kissed her mother-in-law. But Ruth clung to her and said, look, your sister-in-law has gone back to her people and to her gods. Return after your sister-in-law. But Ruth said, "Entreat me not to leave you or turn back from following after you. For wherever you go, I will go. And wherever you lodge, I will lodge. Your people shall be my people and your God, my God. Where you die, I will die. And there will I be buried. The Lord do so to me and more also if anything but death parts you and me." This is the word of God. How did she know that it was the Lord that would do so? Amen. Naomi lived her life out. And by always witnessing it, sometimes using words, her daughter did not want to leave her side. In the book of Jonah, he spent 3 days and three nights in the belly of the fish because he was reluctant to prophesy to the enemy of the nation of Israel, the Assyrians. This lends the question, who am I not to share the gospel with someone that doesn't look like me, walk like me, talk like me, act like me, come from my neighborhood, work in the same building, is down on their luck? Who am I not to witness to them the goodness of God and his salvation? The gospel of Jesus Christ is for the entire world. Why? For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. We'll get to that later. But in Matthew's chapter 1, verse 21, this is Joseph's encounter with the angel. But while he thought about these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take to you Mary, your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. And she will bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins." Jesus came into the world to save mankind from the wrath of God against sin and destroy all the manifestation of the works of Satan. He became sin for us, and he came to reconcile us back to the Father God. Until the Messiah Jesus came, mankind was forever separated from our heavenly Father. There was a covering for sin, and that was the blood sacrifice of animals and bulls and pigeons and goats and even the grain offering. But it wasn't enough to cleanse our souls, to thoroughly take it away. So thank God for his plan for humanity and redemption way back in the Garden of Eden, sharing the good news of the gospel of Jesus Christ. In order to share, and I'm gonna say this, in order to share the gospel of Jesus Christ, others must know and be confident that you're saved. See, how can you share a God that you don't even know? How can you share a God that you aren't in touch with? How can you share a God that you aren't obeying? But we'll get to that. We are to live our lives in a way that is pleasing to God, thus becoming an attraction to those who are on the outside looking in at us. We ought to always witness for Jesus and sometimes use words. At work, I have many things that I've carried with me that I just sit on my desk so other people can see them. I have an I Love Jesus mini bumper sticker, a window sticker. I have a Jesus Paid It All laminated and in my area. I have a little cross that one of the sisters left for me that speaks of Isaiah and knowing the thoughts that God has for us. These become evangelism tools. The Believe that's right here on my t-shirt, on over my shoulder, and what the teens have done in saying that Black life matters by putting that on the shirt. And then when people see it, they say, hey, what does that say? I've even had people ask me about the flag on the sleeve. Are you a veteran? That's an attraction that pulls people in, and that gives us opportunities to share the gospel of Jesus Christ. We've even witnessed recently in our service someone that has come to Jesus Christ after many, many years of one of our parishioners and one of our diakona ministering to this young lady and planting seeds and then watering those seeds. And finally, they've had the opportunity to see God get the increase in this and God get the glory in one of the sheep coming into the fold. One of the 99 that was lost, he came back to get that sheep. And we rejoice, amen. And we rejoice that they've accepted God into their hearts and they are part of the kingdom of God. The same can be said for my son as well. Just through relationships and him fellowshipping at different churches and being with other young men his age and young boys and young girls as he was growing up. Then he went to a conference and he accepted the Lord Jesus into his life. Me bringing him here to Second Baptist Church and everybody here and the love that everybody has for the people of God here poured into him. And he was just constantly being watered. And the seed that I was able to plant and his mother was able to plant and his grandmother was able to plant came to fruition. So praise God that we can just plant seeds and those seeds get watered by other people and God gets the increase. And then when those things are put in motion, then that becomes kinetic. It draws energy and then other people are born into the kingdom of God and other people become citizens of heaven and we rejoice in that. So right where we are, we should share the gospel of Jesus Christ. You don't have to be a pastor. You don't have to be a deacon. You don't have to be a trustee. You can just be a lay person that just loves to let people know about the goodness of God. In Matthew chapter 5, verse 16, it says, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. Let your light shine. Put on the countenance of God. Let his love reign in your hearts and he will draw others to you. 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 12, having your conduct honorable among the Gentiles that they may speak against you as evildoers, they may by your good works which they observe glorify God in the day of visitation. That's a lot to say. This is the word of God. That's a lot to say. Always act right. Always conduct yourself in a godly manner. So then if they happen to have a reason to raise something against you, they say, oh, you know what? No, that's a brother in Christ. That's a Christian young man. That's a Christian young lady. That didn't happen. And I know their testimony. Let us turn to 1 Corinthians chapter 9 and verse 22. And hear what Paul has to say. Amen. Because Paul was on his road, on the road to Damascus, on the road to Damascus to persecute Christians. And then he was knocked off his horse because the things that people do against us, they really do against Christ because we are his children. We are the body of Christ. Amen. And we are the church. We are the bride of Christ. So when people do something that persecutes us, they persecuted him. That's what he says. If they persecuted me, so shall they persecute you. But we're not talking about persecution. We're talking about sharing. So this is what Paul said of his ministry. And he says, serving all men, that in verse 22 of chapter 1, chapter 9, verse 22, to the weak I became as weak, that I might win the weak. I have become all things to all men that I might by all means save some. Amen. Now this I do for the gospel's sake. Amen. This I do for the gospel's sake, that I may be partaker of it with you. This is the word of God. Amen. We must humble ourselves under the mighty hand of God to win others to Christ. We are his ambassadors, as though God were pleading through us, imploring on Christ's behalf for others to be reconciled back to the Father. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 20 and 21. Do not hesitate to pray for those who are around you. If they are going through something, tell them this: I'll be lifting you up in prayer. May I pray for you? Is there anything I can do to help you? Let your light so shine. Let your light shine that others may see and glorify your Father, which is in heaven. Now, when we're sharing, we should also focus on the gospel of Jesus Christ in a way that is not arrogant and condescending. We should be sharing with humility the things that God has done for us. We shouldn't be Bible thumping. You know, we don't want to hit somebody over the head with the Bible and say, you have to repent now or you're going to hell. There's a way to say that without actually placing them in hell. Amen. There's a way to let others know that Jesus died for their sins and that he rose again. Amen. So let's be humble. Let's be kind. Let's be gentle. Let's be patient. Let's share the gospel with the mind of Jesus Christ. Romans chapter 3, verse 10 says, as it is written, there is none righteous, no, not one. For all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. Amen. We have to share like it's us. For God so loved the world, John 3, 16 and 17. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever would believe in him would not perish but have everlasting life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. This is the word of God. This is the gospel in one verse, in two verses. Amen. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 3 and 4. For I delivered to you, first of all, that which I received, that Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he rose again on the third day according to the scriptures. This is the word of God. Let us remember when we are sharing the gospel of Jesus Christ that we're sharing it like we're the ones in need of a Savior. After all, we are. We still need Jesus. Don't think just because you've made a profession of faith that that's it. There's work to do. We're to exercise our time, talents, and treasures. That's what makes evangelism go. is time, spending time telling somebody about who Jesus is, that part of the go. And then exercising our spiritual gifts to edify the body of Christ, times and talents, using your talent to glorify and edify the body of Christ and your treasures. It takes money to print out a t-shirt like that and like these. It takes money to turn the lights on at the church. It takes money to put gas in the car to get somewhere to go to an event. It takes money to support the ministry as a whole. And that's biblical. And that's part of evangelism as well. Amen. So we have to witness also under the power of the Holy Spirit. We need to be prayed up before we witness to people. So in our devotion, we need to leave the house prayed up, so because we never know who we're going to run into on the way to work, on the way to the gas station, in the supermarket. Amen. Amen. The other thing that leads me to is this. We ought to share your testimony or the acts of faith that you have in coming to know who Jesus is. We need to be engaging and approachable, and that's vital to inviting others to get to know the Savior. I can remember we had an event during Christmas time, and we had the table set up and we were under the canopy. And one of the biggest attraction to our table, believe it or not, was not us handsome people and us, you know, great looking men and women of God behind the table. It was some candy packages that Sister Lois Jenkins made. And they were bringing and drawing the young people and even some of the other people that were up in age, 20s and 30s, and even some of the 40 and 50 year olds came over to the table and they wanted to grab a little candy. And we were able to witness to several people just on the basis of them being drawn to our table. We need to be an attraction, like a great big bowl of candy. But we're talking about our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We also need to leave a card in our neighbor's mailbox. We need to pick up sometimes after them, after their dogs have done some stuff in the yard. We need to help them with their groceries and as they pull their groceries out the car. We need to bless our food in the restaurant so that others can see and hold hands and pray over our food so that they can see the gratitude that we have for God's provisions and the things that He's done for us. So let your words be patient and kind and loving and seasoned with salt. And you might say, well, I get all choked up when I get ready to share Jesus Christ. Pray. That's why I said, get a time of devotion where you can go in, and when you leave the house, you'll be prayed up. And you'd be surprised what God will give you to say that He brings back to your memory, because His word says, don't worry about what you'll say, because I'll bring all those things back to your remembrance. And He will bless you with a scripture or with a story. And that may be the one thing that wins that person to Jesus Christ. So keep this in mind, that we are all called to evangelize. Every last man and woman, boy and girl that know who Jesus is called to evangelize. I once heard an evangelistic message from someone that was 7 years old, a young lady, by the way, and oh my goodness, people need to accept the Lord Jesus Christ, and they need to be forgiven of their sins. Otherwise, when they die, they're going to go to hell. And I don't want, and I'm quoting, paraphrasing, I don't want people to go to hell. I want people to go to heaven. Everybody needs to know about Jesus Christ and accept him in their heart. Mm. When I heard that, yeah, tears came to my eyes. How can someone 7 years old have that kind of perspective on her personal relationship with Jesus Christ? But we are to come to the kingdom of God like little children. Amen. Amen. This is what the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 28, verse 18 through 20 says. And Jesus came and spoke to them, saying, "All authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth. Go therefore and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things that I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the age. Amen." This is the word of God as spoken by our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Paul says in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 11 through 12, "And he gave some to be apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, and some pastors and teachers for the equipping of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ." So let us not insist on defining evangelism only in the strictest sense of the word evangelism. Let's communicate God's message to sinners of mercy and of grace to a world that is destined to die without a savior. The world, people are dead in their trespasses and sins, but God can make them alive if they just accept the free gift of eternal life. All they have to do is accept Jesus Christ in their heart, believe that God has raised him from the dead, and they shall be saved. For by their words that shall be justified, by their words that shall be condemned. But not only that, Romans 8 and 9. Yes. Amen. Amen. I want to encourage you on today to know who Jesus really is. Because if we confess with our mouth the Lord Jesus and we believe in our hearts that God has raised him from the dead, whoever says and confesses that shall be saved. But with the heart, man believes unto righteousness. But with the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. And we're not talking about just any Jesus. We're not talking about the Jesus of social media. We're not talking about the Jesus of the occult. We're not talking about the Jesus without judgment. We're not talking about the pink cloud Jesus. We're not talking about just any old Jesus, the Kool-Aid drinking Jesus. We're talking about Jesus of, we're not talking about the namaste, however you say it. We're not talking about that Jesus. We're talking about the one and only Savior of the world who left heaven and came down to earth to get familiar with his creation. Then he lived 33 years and sacrificed himself. He gave himself as an offering, and he hung on the cross as the lamb slain before the foundation of the world. Then he died, stayed dead 3 days, and then on the third day rose with all power in his hand. He walked the earth for 40 days and was seen by multitudes and hundreds of witnesses. And then on the 40th day ascended into heaven to be seated at the right hand of God and enthroned. Psalms 110. And then 10 days later, while the apostles were praying in the upper room, the Holy Spirit was sent down, descended on them on the 50th day, the day of Pentecost, and the church was born. Get to know the Jesus that saved your soul. the Jesus that loves you and forgave you of all of your past, present, and future sins long before you ever committed them. Then share the truth, the true and living Jesus, with everyone in your sphere, as we like to say here at Second Baptist Church. Share Jesus. One of the hardest people to share Jesus with are your unbelieving family. But you have to do it. You have to be the watchman. You have to share Jesus. You have to. It is your responsibility. It is a commandment. Go and make disciples of all nations, teaching them, baptizing them. Share how he saved you from your sins and that you have eternal life and that you'll see Jesus like he is in heaven. That when you leave here from your earthly address, you have a home in glory. Amen. Share Jesus at your home. Share Jesus at work. Share Jesus at the store. Share Jesus with your neighbor. Share Jesus with your friends. Share Jesus on Facebook, on Instagram, on Twitter, on TikTok, on YouTube. Share Jesus with your greeting cards. Share Jesus on your bumper sticker. Share Jesus on your t-shirts. Share Jesus on your baseball caps. Share Jesus on your mask during this pandemic. Share Jesus on your voicemail. Share Jesus at the supermarket. Share Jesus at Starbucks. Share Jesus at church. Share Jesus wherever you go. Let your light shine that others may see your good works and glorify your Father who is in heaven. Let us hold firm to the great commission of our Lord and declare that we are willing, like Paul said, to go anywhere and to do anything in God's will to fulfill this great commission of evangelizing and sharing the gospel of Jesus the Christ. So let's go. Let's make disciples. Let's teach them and baptize them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, that they may observe all the commandments of God. And it's not about a religion. We don't have a religion. We have a relationship with our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. I just want to thank you all for tuning in on Wednesday in the Word. I thank Pastor Chris for this opportunity to share how we can evangelize as men and women of God. There's going to be a number on your screen that should be below me, where you can call. And if you don't know who Jesus is, you can get to know the Savior of the world. He died for you and for me that we might live eternally with him in heaven. There's no sin that is unpardonable. I will repeat that. There is no sin that is unpardonable. The only thing that will keep you out of heaven is you yourself not accepting the free gift of eternal life. For it is by grace that we are saved through faith, not of ourselves, not of any works that we can do, lest any man should boast. We are saved by grace. There's nothing I can do to work my way into heaven, but what I can do is accept Jesus Christ into my heart. And I pray that you would accept Jesus Christ into your heart and that God will come in and take permanent residence in there the moment that you make a confession that Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior. To those of you who already know who Jesus is, you've already made a profession of faith, but you're just out of fellowship, call that number, text that number, and our prayer warriors will pray with you. God says in the Old Testament that he is married to the backslider. In the New Testament, in the book of John, in 1 John 1 and 9, it says, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Oh, all we have to do, right where you are, you're just a prayer away, is to confess our sins. And you will be back in fellowship. Then get with a good Bible teaching and Bible preaching church, like Second Baptist Church, amen. And you can come back into the fellowship and start strengthening your walk and start reading the Bible and start praying and having devotion and developing your relationship with Jesus the Christ. That is my time, and I praise God for this opportunity to share in what we do to bring others into the sheepfold of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Let's recap.
Hello, church family. Thank you for sitting and listening to the Bible study on evangelism in Wednesday in the Word. However, some practical application needs to be applied to what you've just heard. Quite simply, the gospel is this: for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. So if someone comes up to you and asks you, well, how can I be saved? Just simply share that scripture and then ask them, are you willing to let the Lord live inside your heart and take up permanent residence in your life so that you can have eternal life? And they may say, yes, I'm willing. And then you can simply just pray with them. For those who are a little more seasoned, take them down Romans Road, Romans 3:10, for it is written that there's none righteous, no, not one. 3:23, for all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. 6:23, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life by Christ Jesus. Romans 5:8, for God demonstrated his own love towards us and that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. And then Romans 10:9 and 10 says that if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For with the heart man believes unto righteousness, but with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. And then Romans chapter 10 verse 13 says, for whosoever calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. So just be willing to share Jesus with anyone in your sphere, in your atmosphere, and watch God do the work of ushering men and women, boys and girls, into the kingdom of God. I shared this in the video earlier that I once heard a seven-year-old share the gospel of Jesus Christ with someone. So it is just quite simple. It can be as something as practical as a prayer written on a card, the salvation poem. It could be anything that you have available to lead someone to Jesus. So by the grace of God, I pray that God would line up men and women for you to have the opportunity to share the gospel with. And remember those two scriptures, John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believed in him should not perish, but has everlasting life. Please continue to pray for all those who will come into the kingdom of God. And it just might be that by you being wise, by winning souls, you may have the opportunity to win one for the kingdom of God. God bless each and every one of you. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. Jesus Christ, in God, in the name of Jesus, by the power of the Holy Spirit, let us pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I just thank you and I praise you for this day, for this opportunity to share how we as men and women of God can evangelize in the root of it and what it means, Father God. I just thank you, Lord, that you would be edified and glorified through what's been said, Father God. Please, once again, forgive us of our sins. Those who are out there, Father God, that need prayer, whether they be sick and shut in, Father God, whether they be lonely, whether they be homeless, Father God, whether they need a job, whether they need a healing, Father God, whether they need to have money or they need direction and purpose, Lord, answer their prayers, be there for them and with them, Father God, as they cry out to you, Lord, help them. For you are an ever-present help in the time of need. So I just thank you, Lord, for this opportunity that Pastor Chris has bestowed upon me. And I just thank God for Wednesday in the Word. Bless us, Father God, as we leave this Bible study, but never from your presence, to be with you always and to be mindful of you. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Thank you and praise God. Please continue to be safe and bless the Lord.
Amen. Yeah! Let's go! Come on!
Let's recap.
Woo!
Let's recap.
Everybody get your hands up!
Pastor Christopher Bourne and the Building Commission are excited to announce that everyone will have an opportunity to walk through the sanctuary to see the beautiful remodel that has been done on Sunday, June 27th, 2021, following our morning worship service. Further details will be given on Sunday at the end of the worship service.
Topical Bible study for Wednesday in the Word. Explore the Bible using everyday questions. Where is God when? What is faith and how do I use it? Forgiveness. What if God doesn't fix the situation? Obedience. Join us Wednesdays at 7.
SBC Ministry Leaders, we are planning a virtual Second Baptist Church semi-annual convocation. This year's annual convocation will take place on Wednesday, June 30th at 6 p.m.
Let each one give as he purposes in his heart, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loves a cheerful giver. We have three ways to give here at Second Baptist Monrovia. You can go on our website, sbcmonrovia.org/give. You can mail your tithes and offering to P.O. Box 479, Monrovia, California, 91017, or you can download the Give Plus app and search for Second Baptist Church of Monrovia.
You know what's better than praying by yourself? Having a corporate prayer, a group prayer. Join us every first Wednesday of the month at 6 p.m. Check the posting for more information.
And those are your announcements for this week.